We have seen the qualitative features of the solutions of the logistic equation, but can we solve the equation analytically for a more quantitative result? Yes, we can. We have a separable differential equation, and as it turned out, the integrals are not that hard at all, so let us take a look. So, here we have our logistic equation, dp dt equals k times p times 1 minus p over m, with some initial population, k growth rate and m carrying capacity. Then you can separate, because you have only p's on the right hand side and no t's at all, so you can just put all p's on the left and all t's on the right. And then the right hand side becomes very easy, and the left hand side becomes slightly messy. Then we have to integrate. Well, integrating right hand side is trivial, so let us focus on the left hand side first. We can integrate this, but we have to separate the fraction first. So this 1 over p times 1 minus p over m equals something over p plus something else over 1 minus p over m. And then multiply this term with 1 minus p over m, so over here, and multiply this term with p, and combine. And then you see that this numerator has to be equal to 1 for all p's. So that means in particular that a has to be equal to 1. And this term and that term have to cancel out. The term's proportional to p. So minus a over m plus b has to equal to 0. A being equal to 1 means b equals 1 over m. So that means that we can integrate the a over p, so 1 over p, plus the other term with the 1 over m in front with respect to p. And the derivative of 1 over p equals the log of p, with absolute value. And the antiderivative of the other term, the log of minus 1 minus p over m. For example, the substitution rule, you can check now by differentiating. The log of 1 minus p over m equals 1 over 1 minus p over m times minus 1 over m, with the additional minus sign gives you exactly this term. And then you can combine the two logs into one term. It gives you the log of the absolute value of p over 1 minus p over m. And as integral equals the integral on the right hand side, well, the integral on the right hand side is easy to just k times t plus c1. So you can take exponentials on left and right. So you get the absolute value of p over 1 minus p over m equals exponential of k times t plus c1. And of course, we want to solve p. We want to have p explicitly as function of t. So now we'll try to figure out what p is. Well, first we do the familiar trick. E to the power k times t plus c1 equals e to the power k times t times e to the power c1. And you rename e to the power c1 to c2 over here. And then how do we get rid of the absolute value? Now the expression on the left-hand side is either positive or negative. If it's positive, you just pick the c3 equal to c2. If it would be negative, you pick c3 equals minus c2. So you basically put the sign of the absolute value also in your arbitrary constant, which was arbitrary anyway. So you have your p over 1 minus p over m equals some constant times e to the power kt. Still want to have p explicitly in terms of t. Now it's we have it basically vice versa. We have t in terms of p, but we want to have p in terms of t. So what do we do? Well, it's best now to use the initial condition first to determine the constant. We have to do it anyway, but it's best to do it now in this case. So p of 0 equals p0. Then plugging in t equals 0 on the right gives you the c3. T equals 0 on the left gives you p0 over 1 minus p0 over m. So your this becomes your c3. And put this whole mass on the right hand side for a moment in the number alpha. Because we want to have p explicitly. We will first solve p in terms of alpha. And if you have solved p in terms of alpha, so if p equals something and alpha's on the right hand side, then we put the mass back. So, first solve P. Well, P equals 1 minus P over M times alpha. Then what do we have? We keep the alpha on the right-hand side and put the P over M times alpha to the left. So we get the P times 1 plus alpha over M equals alpha. And then we can solve for P by dividing by 1 plus alpha over M. So we get P equals alpha divided by 1 plus alpha over M. And then we put back what alpha is. That's this incredible expression here. So it looks quite scary now. So we put the alphas back over there and over there. And we start to clean up some of the mess. Fortunately, that's possible. You can multiply by capital M first. So that's what we do. Multiply by capital M here and here. And take the 1 over M in here. So it gives you an M minus P0. So it's already cleans up some of the mass. And then in the next step, multiply by M minus P0. So that means that they are cancelled out here and there. And you get the M minus P0 over there, as we have over here. And what you often do is that you then take out the P0. So there you have your P of T slightly cleaned up, or alternatively, you can write it like this. If you divide this expression over here by e to the power kt. So why is this second formula more convenient? Well, from the second formula, you can easily see what happens if t goes to infinity. If t goes to infinity, your e to the power minus kt will cancel out, so this term cancels out, and you'll get for t to infinity, your population approaches capital M. So here you see that you could find the solution of your logistic problem analytically, slightly technical maybe, but still it's nice to see because it confirms what we already saw qualitatively, that if you take limit time to infinity, that your population will approach your carrying capacity.